newsletter that I just published as an Adobe PDF. Well, now I'm ready to take that newsletter and put it on my teacher website so that parents can view it. So the next step is to log into your Brandywine Heights teacher website dashboard. And I'm going to find my site right here. That's me, Katie Hess, and I'm going over here to where it says dashboard, and I'm going to click on that. That's going to bring me to this like behind the scenes page that lets me manage the items that are on my website. If I go over here to media and click on it, this is where I need to go to upload that newsletter, and I need to go to add new. These are all the files that I currently have in my media library, but the one that I need is the January 9th newsletter. So going over here, I like to click on select files. And if you remember, I saved that PDF to my desktop, so I can look for it by scrolling down. I could also type up here, search desktop, Kinder News, January 9th, and there it is. So I select it, I click open, and it just added the newsletter right here. So what I'm going to do is double click on that. Over here on the right is the URL that is specific to that newsletter. I'm going to click three times, click, click, click. That highlights the entire thing. Now I'm going to right click, while my arrow is still on the blue, I'm going to right click and click copy. Now that URL is copied, and I'm going to go immediately back to my dashboard by closing this window right here, back to my dashboard to pages, because I need to view all the pages that I have, and I have a newsletter page already set up. And once it opens it, I can see it's right here. This is my newsletter page, and just by putting my mouse on top of the title of my newsletter page, edit, quick edit, trash, and view come up. So I'm going to click on edit. And January 9th, of course, is already on here, but I just want to show you for demonstration purposes how you can add a link with this newsletter that you just did. So I'm going to put my cursor up here at the top, and I'm going to type January 9th newsletter. Now, I am going to highlight January 9th newsletter right up here, this little link. This is where I need to insert that URL that I've copied from my newsletter. I click Insert Edit Link button, and up here, if I highlight HTTP, I want to just right click and paste, and there's the January 9th newsletter URL that I copied previously. Click Add Link. This is a really important part. I need to click Update before I do anything else. And now it's been updated. I can click View Page and test out my link. When I click on View Page, it brings me to what parents would actually see. And here's my new January 9th newsletter link. I click on that, and voila, there is my PDF January newsletter.